Hello and welcome to my video of showing you how to fix this problem that you might have when you switch on your DX7S. Change battery. The battery is actually soldered to the main board, and if you don't have any juice left in your battery, you can see the display is just gobbledygook. So we'll have to take the back cover off. So I'm just turning over the synthesizer here and rapidly remove all the screws, remembering which ones go where. Some of them are slightly different from the others, in the corners in particular. So the battery that's in the DX7 is a standard, well, can be replaced by a standard CR2032 battery. So as I remove the back cover here, you'll see the board on the left hand side of the screen, my right, this one here. It's where the battery actually is. We can't see it until we take the board out. So there's a few more screws to be removed. So this is the board that contains the battery and a lot of the sockets on the back, as you can see, for the MIDI and all the outputs. So just pull that out carefully, and there's a couple of wire looms with connectors on one side. Just there's just two that you can remove. You take them and then you careful, you can leave the others in place. And you can see here the battery now that I'm just about to point out here on the motherboard, or the main, it's not the motherboard, on the board. So that battery there is just soldered completely on. So on the back here, where I'm pointing with the screwdriver, is where the two points are that need to be desoldered. So grab it carefully, getting hold of the battery on the other side and using a soldering iron, just gradually heat the pins on either side of the battery. You can see that just got that one off mainly. Just get rid of some of the excess solder here. You might use a desoldering gun while doing this, really, but I managed to do without. I was being a bit lazy. Just getting the last pin out here, and there you go. That's the old battery out. And as you can see, it's completely soldered together. There's no battery holder or anything. It's just an orange piece of plastic to protect the positive and negative. So I've taken a piece of headphone wire here. Quite handy to remember some solder rules here. Always tin the iron, put some solder on the soldering iron, the ends of your wires, add fresh solder as you're soldering, and get everything to the same heat. So as I'm just pushing the wire through here, getting it ready on the other side of the board, I'll bring in my soldering iron, tinning the iron as you can see, following the rules, and then bringing some fresh solder in onto the wire that's already been tinned. I didn't show you that on the headphone wire I used. Getting the solder joint nice there, just checking it, making sure it's all right. Now I need to push the wire through for the other side, for the positive and negative side. The positive is on the right, as you see it on the screen here, and the negative on the left, which is reversed depending on which way you're looking at it. So just adding in the second wire here, check it again, and that means now that the main wire is there ready, and we're going to need to just check that it's held in okay, and just neatly wrap the piece of wire that's there behind before we look at the battery holder. So this battery holder I got on eBay for a couple of euros, a couple of pins on there which I've already pre-tinned. So I'm just going to need to also solder the other ends of the headphone wire to the right place. Check your positive and negative. Positive is the top of the battery, and negative the bottom of the battery. So the top of the battery where the writing's on it. If you look at the holder, you can see which connector is going to actually touch the top of the battery and work out which one's positive, and negative will be the other one. That's what I think I've just done. Positive there, and soldering the negative here. So now, after we've got that there in, just to do a continuity check, so the meter should just go completely over to the other side. So I've got the, just checking there that there's continuity between the two points. I make sure that my wire's okay and that my soldering's okay, and there's no short circuit when I touch other places. So now it's time to put the cables back in from the looms to this, well, it's a child board, isn't it, or something, I don't know what you call it, this particular piece of circuitry anyway. So attach those wires back in and then neatly line up the MIDI ports and the output ports and everything. Just check that's seated nicely. There's two holes there that have got screws in. You don't actually have to take those out, I don't think. I think I did, but I don't think you have to. So we'll put all the screws back in on this board. Make sure that doesn't move around anymore. And secure that fine. Now, take out my battery. So I've got a multi-pack online of these 2032 batteries. And clip it in the battery holder, which is just freely floating around at the moment. So push that battery in the battery holder. Now's a good time to check that we've got voltage correct across that battery. So there we can see the positive and negative, because red's the positive and the negative, and you can see the reading goes up. I've just found this neat little place in a kind of current wire loom already that I could just put the battery holder in just by pushing it in there, really. So I'm just adding some insulating tape to hold it there. There's probably better ways of doing this, perhaps with cable ties or something. You could come up with a better system, but this will be good enough for me. I don't kid with the keyboard anymore, so it's just in my little music room and it won't be shaken around very much. But I think this is quite adequate for my needs. So if I do ever run the battery down again and still have the synth, I will have to change it. And now the job done is simply a case of putting the back cover back on and screwing it up again. Obviously this took me a lot more time than what you're seeing on the video, and not including the sped up parts, because I've been editing this a little bit down and I've watched a few videos to see how other people have done it. Not a job for the faint-hearted, not much soldering to do, and quite a few screws to take out. There's nothing particularly fragile, you know, take your usual precautions. Now, when we switch it back on again, we've still got gobbledygook on our internal voices. So we fixed the battery problem because it's not giving us the warning anymore. If you press edit 16 and 32 together, you see this little status display, so we can see the voltage on the battery is okay. Now, if we go into the menus by using edit and then pressing 14 and 15, switch the protection on internal and cartridge to off. So we can copy from the cartridge that came with the DX7. We can load up from the bank one and get the internal voices back to mellow horn and vibrato and everything. And we need to set the bank for the cartridge memory to 2 again, so that the cartridge is giving us from bank 2 and the internal ones we just saw. So cartridge on 2 gives us all the bass sounds. Put the internal and cartridge protection back on. And then all we need to do is pack up your tools and put the keyboard away, or put it back on its stand and play it and have fun. Now, I've had some problems with the sound on my DX7, so if anyone knows why, there's a bit of a... dirty finish, filtery, not so clean sound when you finish off a sound, let me know.